Correct indeed. We'll move on now to Michelle Hopper, who, as I said earlier, is going to talk about the ARMO feasibility study. Thank you very much indeed, Michelle.
Yeah, good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you, Mr. Chairman, giving me the opportunity to have a short, brief instruction about first results of a feasibility study we made concerning the ARMO using the MF transmissions. And I also like to thank the authors of the results from Lion Research in the States and the company of Aberdeen GmbH in Germany. So first I like shortly to introduce the R-mode idea. So the R-mode, so-called ranging mode, is an add-on of an accurate synchronized timing signal on existing terrestrial maritime radio infrastructure. So the idea is really to look what is existing in the maritime world, what infrastructure is there, and here we find that globally distributed in the maritime field is the MF radio beacon service, which is currently used for DGNSS correction transmission. And all over the world we have AIS shore-based services. So these systems are available, and the idea is, could they be used for transmission of timing synchronized timing signals? And on the other hand, also the idea of a combination of rural terrestrial radio signals. So the feasibility study is split up in three parts. First part is the investigation of the ARMO based on the existing radio beacons. The second part is then looking in the investigation of an ARMO based on the existing AIS shore infrastructure, and part three is then looking to the combination of various systems which are available, which meaning radio beacons together with AIS or with IRORA. So the first results, what we are now having on place is results for part one based on the transmission using the radio beacon infrastructure. So this results take into account some technical issues like pitch transition and carrier phase tracking. We are using variance matrix to calculate the achievable performance with respect to timing and ranging accuracy, propagation conditions, geometry of the various beacons infrastructure which we have, especially in the North Sea area. This is where we focus this project, concerning also to the AXIS project here. Then we take into account noise, interference, and skywave. The first real result, and I think this is very interesting to see, is when we are just looking to the geometry metric in the North Sea area, the so-called H-dot factor, from existing installations in the North Sea. So this is what we get when we are combining all the infrastructure which is available in the North Sea area. And so this is not just, so to say, an artificial result. It's based on the geometry, but it's also based on signal to noise ratio figures which are taken into account, and an extra noise pattern which we add to it. Just to give an idea about achievable ranging or timing accuracy, when we are looking, for example, of a signal to noise ratio of 25 dB, this will result in less than 10 nanoseconds in timing accuracy, which is the same as within a 3 meter range when it comes to ranging. With respect to the position accuracy, and here we took into account the geometry and also the different factors I presented before, And here we have on the left side, we see the daytime accuracy. You see the scale, which is going from in the blue area in the range of 10 to 20 meters up to 100 meter when it comes to the red figures. And it shows that during the daytime we could achieve a 10 to 20 meter accuracy figure with armored. And in the nighttime, there's a degradation due to the sky wave effect, but it is still within 100 meter, which is one threshold when it comes to IMO requirements. And so these are really first results. And so what we like to do is to continue the work regarding the feasibility study based on AIS transmissions, and also to look to the combinations of various systems. And we believe especially what we see with the SkyWave could be dramatically reduced when we are combining different systems. And I think this gives us a good hope that the armored also on the radio beacon during the night could be solved. And another issue is that we would like to perform practical tests within the EXES project the remaining time, at least a proof of concept to make sure that the results we found in the theoretical basis, so to say, that we could make sure that they are also achievable in practical tests. So, conclusions. Armored on MF radio beacons is feasible. We saw that we could achieve a 3 meter range error, and we could achieve with existing installations around the North Sea already a system which enabled us to navigate within 10 to 20 meters daytime. And we hope we could also increase performance during the nighttime and combining it with other systems or adding some special developments with sky wave reduction possibilities. Also, the existing infrastructure on radio beacons in the North Sea already provide very good coverage, as it is. Good coverage and geometry. And another very important issue is only minor modifications are required. So the only thing we have to do is to add a timing source to it and to have a modulator which accepts the timing from outside. And the standard using this kind of method is more or less is not affected by it. So we can, in parallel, also provide the legacy signal for the DGNSS corrections. And further improvements can result from the combination with other existing infrastructure, as we have with the AIS shore infrastructure in most of the countries around the world, or Iran in regional view. Okay, thank you very much for your attention, and I hope, thanks again, to be able to present this very first results during that conference. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed, Michelle. And are you now going to report on the more details behind that to the partners? Is that later today?
Yeah, that's right. So we have time this afternoon after the exhibition, so we are meeting at the Northern Lighthouse Board. I think it's around 3 p.m. Is that correct? At the Northern Lighthouse Board. So this is giving some more detailed information on the feasibility study to the partners, also with respect to testbed and so on.
Well, other than recognizing this clever, I'm not going to ask a question because it's way beyond me. Are there any questions, please, about the ARMO from this audience, please? Mance's boss.
Yes. Well, not a question, actually, but just thank you for this. This was very encouraging information, very much so, I think. So this is very important news, breaking news, actually.